Hello, my love bugs. Welcome back to Kara's Love Techniques. So today I just want to come to you with a quick video about how to tell if your partner is materialistic or a materialistic partner. All right, so firstly, you know, you may not see the signs right away with a lot of people. Then there are others that you can tell right away if someone's materialistic just by the way they present themselves, pretty much how they go about life. You can actually see that this person is materialistic. Now, if you choose to be with that person after seeing this and your observation, well then that's on you. However, there are others that you may not be able to detect right away that you have a materialistic partner. And in a lot of cases, both partners are materialistic. Now, what we have here in that case, that's sort of, you know, disastrous because, you know, typically the relationship is going to be built on superficial things. And when you have a partner who's materialistic or materialistically minded, they're so superficial, shallow, they put their ego and their appearance above anything else. When you have that, it takes away from what is needed to have a healthy, successful relationship. All right, so your conversations may be about money, nonetheless. Who's making more? Are you gonna make more money? Can we do this? Are we going to do this? Or so-and-so, they just purchased this. You know, it's always gonna be like this competition with the outside world. Or maybe even to just fulfill some sort of void. So, and this could be a lot of reasons why people become materialistic, because they want to make up for, you know, shortcomings or things that they've lacked in their lives, like actual love. And so, yeah, when you have a materialistic partner, you're always going to seek more. You may start out, if you're residing together, you may start out living in, you know, a two-bedroom apartment. Okay, so the next year, he or she, or maybe both of you, want to move into a townhouse, a three-bedroom townhouse, and it gets more, and they always want a different car. It's always going to become something more, okay? And what happens, a lot of times this also happens in marriages. You know, they marry someone who's materialistic and they want a bigger house, bigger car. And then you have the partner who's willing to make that happen. So what happens, right, is that in this case, you know, it becomes overwhelming. Time is taken away from the relationship. You have a partner who's working, or both partners are overworking to keep up, unless you have it like that now. Unless you've got it to where you don't have to stress over funds and money or whatever, then, you know, then again, hey, it may work. But in most cases, a partner or both partners begin to stress over money, over working too much, not spending enough time together. You may have one partner who's putting in more hours, and then the other partner is deprived at home emotionally with lack of affection, lack of attention, dealing with the kids. And so when that gets in the way, because you're trying to build something more that you really don't need, you know, if you don't have to have it, if it's not a major necessity, I mean, you're working yourself pretty much for nothing, because what happens is your relationship is torn apart. That destroys your relationship. You guys begin to lose yourself in hopes of trying to keep up in appearances. And that's not healthy, because it strains you. Now you have to maintain that lifestyle. See, it may be a challenge to get to that point, to look up or whatever, and to have the best. And there's nothing wrong with wanting the finer things in life if you can afford it. But when you have to work so hard to get to that point, and then try to maintain that level of a lifestyle, it's stressful. And then, so what happens when you can't? Now you're fighting over money. Now there's a disconnect in the relationship. And the whole dynamic changes. So, and ironically, a lot of times this happens in marriages. You know, they go out of their way to get a bigger this, a bigger, you know, better that, and to make themselves happy in hopes that this is going to create a better lifestyle for themselves. Ironically, those very same things that they purchase to have a happier home are what they end up fighting for in the end. Who gets the house? Who gets the car? Who gets the kids? See? Because they didn't really need those things to begin with. In order to have a relationship, okay, you have to focus on love and everything that it entails. Attention, affection, dedication, devotion, you know, listening, talking to your partner, spending time together. Those are the things that make for a healthy relationship. But if you try to factor in these other little gadgets and gadgets to make it brighter, so you can look better, so you can feel better about living in life, and you think this is the American dream. Well, it takes a lot to have the American dream, okay? You have to actually be able to afford the American dream. Otherwise, you're being sold a dream. Pipe dreams. So yeah, it's a strain to be with someone who's materialistic. And how do you deal with a partner who's materialistic? Well, for one, we really don't want that person to change, right? Because when a person change and they go from being one way to having to just be frugal and settle for less, they're not going to be all that content. So my advice is to just probably, no matter how much you care for this person, okay, is to probably just get out of the relationship and you know, live your lifestyle how you choose versus trying to make someone change how they live their life, right? And if it's just so happened that both of you are materialistic, well, find other ways to feel, you know, I don't know, good about yourself outside of all the material things, buying rings and jewelry and doing all this extra stuff is really not necessary, okay? It really isn't. And yeah, so I just wanted to share that with you about a materialistic partner and how to somewhat deal with it. I mean, there really isn't much that you can do about a materialistic partner. You can tell them, hey, I can't afford you. Could you just like calm down some or just be without, you know? Yeah, sorry. But that's my time, guys. I thank you so much for joining me, my little love bugs. I thank you, I thank you, I thank you. Be sure to comment, subscribe, and share. And yeah, until next time, take care.